Hey there, I'm looking for Charles Seeker. You know where I could find him?
And you are?
Zachariah Mancer. Professor and I have a mutual friend who's worried about him.
I know the feeling. Haven't seen him for days. I'm Veronica Seeker, the professor's assistant. I got a message informing me he had taken an impromptu vacation, but it's not like him. He didn't even like to sleep, said it just wasted time. Even more unlikely in the middle of the...
Yeah, seems a bit off, doesn't it? Professor was supposed to start some research with a friend of mine as well. I'm sure he'd already started work on it before leaving. You know anything about it?
I, of course, know the subject of his investigations, but as the one you're interested in has yet to be completed or published, I can't help you.
If you're concerned that the message wasn't really from the professor, did you report his disappearance?
To the authorities? Of course not. The authorities, Mr. Mancer, have far more pertinent issues than this, which I'm sure will work itself out in time. Now, if you'll excuse me.
It's a damn shame. I have to admit, I would have loved to meet the man myself. Heard so many great things. Even read his work in genetics regarding the origins of the primoselfia earthlings with abundance. Brilliant man.
And the truth is, he would have been just as interested in meeting you. Technomancers fascinated him, though I'm fairly certain he'd never met one who had ever read his publications. I'm afraid the professor's vocal railings against the ASC and their ceaseless power grabs might have finally come back to bite him. He would even preach to his colleagues and the listeners at conferences. I would give anything to be wrong, of course, but hope is oftentimes incongruous with the reality we must come to face.
That's one good-looking woman. Too bad she's only got eyes for her, professor.
You girls seem so sad. Lieutenant, why are we investigating the professor's disappearance?
The captain never discussed it.
You're a dead man.
It's not our order.
I've been working on something that'll help us in the long run. Something really important. I don't know how it's connected to this.
I'd advise you to not try.
You're gonna have to trust me.
Oh, I get it. You just want to solve a case on your own. I got your back, Lieutenant.
I'd advise you to not try anything. I'd advise you to not try anything. Make the slightest move, you're a dead man.
Hey there, Fiorello.
Ah, the one, the only, Zachariah Manson. A pleasure, as always. What brings you here this fine day?
I see they got you the mutant.
Yes, yes, a wonderful specimen. Words and all.
Beg! Mutant! Call! Beg!
Beautiful! Yes, Beg! And his sheer size. Like he was simply built to dissuade any ill-intentioned folks from bothering us. Here, here, take this. To compensate you for all you've done. And feel free anytime to request any favor in return.
Listen, maybe I can help. What's going on?
You are too kind. I am so deeply indebted to you. Anyway, yes, I am a little worried. More than a little, to be truthful. Two of my regular clients, after the kidnapping, must have assumed the worst and just left. Haven't heard from them. No one but you, I admit, cared enough to come to look for me. That said, their merchandise is here, but I have no way of telling them I am back without the risk of exposing myself. I don't mean to treat you like my errand boy. I only ask because you offered your help. Anyway, if you could let them know, I could compensate you as well. One of them, I'm sure you know, the barracks quartermaster. The other one is a slums merchant.
You know where the merchant's at?
Of course, of course. If you have a map, I could show you. Bless you, man, sir. A thousand times over, bless you for all you've done for me.
Lucky you. Glad to see you. Can't tell you how much your help was. It is appreciated. Oh, things might have worked themselves out in time, but who has time these days? And you sure saved me the hassle. You're a technomancer?
I am. Zachariah Manser.
I'm lucky. In name and in life. You Mansers all stick together. Know each other real well, don't you?
Know each other maybe, but we're scattered between here and the front.
Right, right! The front. Of course the front. So, I take it you know where I can find a... I believe his name is Master Connor?
He's still in town, away from the front, training recruits.
Lucky again. Just what I wanted to hear. Think you might be up to do me a favor?
Either way, I'm here. Tell me what you need.
Simple. To meet Master Connor and relay some information. With your help, of course. Without your help, well, being just a simple merchant, unwelcome outside the exchange, I suppose it'd be a bit harder. If not, you know, impossible. You know as well as I do, a common merchant can't just stroll up to the likes of a master. So, you get me in front of him, and I'll owe you one. How about that?
I'll see what I can do.
And I'll be much obliged.
Man! Nice man! Help, Bang! Please? Bang soon leave with Master Merchant. Bang need help, Man Lightning.
I guess that I can bring the stone, yes. It's a very nice drawing that you made.
Yes! Man Lightning, nice! Give Master to Bang. Bang have memory for Mother. Make himself. You go give memory to Mother Bang?
Is it me you're calling Man Lightning?
Man, nice! Man, very nice!
Where are you from, Bang? Have you worked in the pen for a long time?
Bang, not know. Several, many nights?
It's not gonna be easy to get anything from him. Goodbye, Bang.
Goodbye!
Hi.
Lieutenant, how can I help you?
I went to a friend for a solution to our antidote problem, and he found one.
That's the kind of good news you don't get every day. You could stop 100 terrorist attacks and still not save as many lives as you have with that antidote, Lieutenant.
Hi.
Lieutenant, how can I help you?
Hey, Ryan. Merchant just delivered this for you. Said he's got more merch you may be interested in, too.
Oh, good. Bastard finally showed up. Damn foreigners. Good thing they're better at making deals than they are at minding their clocks or calendars.
Master Connor isn't in the chapel. I think the Great Master will know where he is.
Zachariah, a pleasure as always. What may I do for you?
Are you so sure that it's a spy?
Indeed. The details of your mission were so specific that they were assuredly gained firsthand. So unless you are spreading the information yourself, who else is left but Captain Eliza and your men? Whoever it is, make sure they see nothing else. Ensure that our secret is kept safe.
I'm looking for Master Connor. Any idea where I can find him?
He headed down to the Underworks, needed to get some supplies from our warehouses. If you're going there, take the elevator near the barracks. Opens up close to the warehouses and will save you some time. It's a real maze down there.
Thanks for the tip. Are you so sure that it's a spy?
Indeed. The details of your mission were so specific that they were assuredly gained firsthand. So unless you are spreading the information yourself, who else is left but Captain Eliza and your men? Whoever it is, make sure they see nothing else. Ensure that our secret is kept safe.
Dear, dear Zachariah, a pleasure as always to see you, and my gratitude for your help. Now, please, stop calling me Master. You're one of us now. What brings you here?
I met a merchant fresh off the exchange who'd like to meet you.
Strange. Some delivery I'm not expecting, or something else?
He only said he had information to give. Didn't say what, but I thought maybe there was a chance he learned something about some relics during his travels.
Relics are more of the Great Master's field of expertise than mine. I like to stick to molding our young recruits, but come, let us see what this is all about.
Going on, but this is weird. Better follow Master Connor to the exchange to make sure nothing happens to him.
Really, you? Andrew? Can it really be?
I hate to disappoint Master Connor, but I don't die easy. And I have a little too much pride to just let myself be tossed out with the trash. We got some explaining to do.
We did not toss you out with the trash. We just did not know how to help you. Your talents were uncontrollable. So we sent you away, hoping you would forget. Move on.
Hoping I'd forget? When? As 10 years of my life wasted away at the hands of a merchant? I want my goddamn life back, asshole.
I'm so sorry. I don't know how I could make it up to you. I
don't know. But you can be damn sure I'll think of something. Get out.
Andrew, I cannot tell you how remarkable to see you. Simply remarkable. Pardon me, Zachariah. You cannot know how unexpected this was. Thank you. I must now return to the source.
Ooh, who'd have fucking thought it? A technomancer spying on other technomancers. Crazy shit right there. From where I've stood, it looks like you were all stuck together tight as hell. Shows what I know.
Keep your mouth shut.
I'm just shocked, Lieutenant, that's all. Shocked and, just shocked.
Sorry if this is out of line, Lieutenant, but why the hell are we helping a mutant? Seems like a waste of time. Something the captain might not.
Because I said so. It won't take long.
Make the slightest move, you're a dead man.
Hey there.
Officer, hello. What can I do for the fine officer today? Check out my merchandise. I have everything you'd ever need for hunting.
Hey there. Just came by to let you know Fiorello's back in the exchange, and he's got your merchandise.
Now that is some very good news. Thank you. I'll send my assistant right away.
Thank you. You came. Thank you. Let's get going as soon as possible.
I actually have something to do first, though. So just wait here.
Sure. Sure. Please, hurry, though. I have a bad feeling they're onto me. And if so, they could be coming to kill me at any minute. Thank you. You came!
All right, let's go.
Hey there, I'm looking for Charles Seeker. You know where I could find him?
And you are?
Zachariah Mancer. Professor and I have a mutual friend who's worried about him.
I know the feeling. Haven't seen him for days. I'm Veronica Seeker, the professor's assistant. I got a message informing me he had taken an impromptu vacation, but it's not like him. He didn't even like to sleep, said it just wasted time. Even more unlikely in the middle of the research he was doing.
Yeah, seems a bit off, doesn't it? Professor was supposed to start some research with a friend of mine as well. I'm sure he'd already started work on it before leaving. You know anything about it?
Of course. I was involved with the professor's research, though I shouldn't discuss it with anyone without his consent. But with that last name, Mancer, I suppose this technomancy research is of particular interest to you. Otherwise, most people barely bat an eye towards the scientific aspects of technomancer powers.
If you're concerned that the message wasn't really from the professor, did you report his disappearance?
To the authorities? Of course not. The authorities, Mr. Mancer, have far more pertinent issues than this, which I am sure will work itself out in time. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Veronica, I know I'm not exactly a prime physical specimen, but I should hope that I am still not so forgettable. Unless I'm wrong and we do not know each other. What is, after all, certain in this life? It might all just be a confounding dream. Like the one I had last night, where trying to wear my pants as a shirt, I found my nose got caught in the zipper.
Professor Scott! Oh my! Hello! I am so sorry I did not recognize you. You should have told me earlier to save me from this embarrassment. Was it you who was planning a collaboration on the technomancer research? I'm afraid the professor's vocal railings against the ASC and their ceaseless power grabs might have finally come back to bite him. He would even preach to his colleagues and the listeners at conferences. I would give anything to be wrong, of course, but hope is oftentimes incongruous with the reality we must come to face.
Hi, Scott.
Hello, my boy. How are you? Nothing broken, I hope.
How long have you known Amelia?
Since she was a kid. She was quite a cute child, yet so agitated. She's actually no different. She is still agitated and doesn't realize the risks she takes. Mark was more cautious. I really hope that she'll become more careful. I would be very sad if something happened to her. Sometimes I have the feeling that she thinks I'm a tiresome old man. It would be a problem. I mean, I'm not that annoying, am I?
Tell me more about your friend, Mark Reacher.
I don't really like to stir up old memories about him. His disappearance. I miss him, you know. He really was a very good friend. We met when we were young. I was researching animal mutations. But, of course, I didn't have a specimen in town. My professor introduced me to a young Mark Reacher who had a promising future. He took me hunting. It was amazing. There were so many things to discover out there. It was the first time that I went out, whereas Mark had already been exploring the canyon mother since his early years. The shop was enormous. I wanted to get out of the rover all the time, run after a beast, or collect a plant specimen. Mark would obviously prevent me from doing so. It was funny. He was an adventurer, but he was, in the end, more reasonable than the naive scientist that I was. And it remained like that until he went missing. Zachariah, could you... Anyway, could I talk to you in private?
What's going on?
I know that I'm asking a lot of you, but I was wondering if maybe... you could continue to investigate. You are someone important now. You know a lot of people. They can tell you if Veronica's suspicions are justified.
I could probably talk about it with my captain, tap into some contacts in the know.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. I want to be sure, you see. I think that you need to recover his latest research. I strongly believe that, besides what he said, he found something dangerous. The ASC, they're thugs. We must not allow sensitive scientific research to fall into their hands. The risks are too high.
I'll see what I can do, but I doubt that Veronica will give me Charles's documents willingly. She's very protective of her boss's work.
Why did Charles start thinking of politics? Politics has no place in the scientific community. It's such a plebeian concept. Now, look at poor Veronica. She's like a lost soul.
What girl seems so sad? Lieutenant, why are we investigating the professor's disappearance?
The captain never discussed it. It's not our order.
I've been working on something that'll help us in the long run. Something really important. I don't know how it's connected to this, but it is. You're gonna have to trust me.
Oh, I get it. You just want to solve a case on your own. I got your back, Lieutenant!
Hey there, Fiorello.
Ah, the one, the only,
I see they got you the mutant.
Yes.
Beg! Mutant! Call!
Beautiful! Yes, beg!
Listen, maybe I can help. What's going on?
You are too kind. I am two of my regular clients after the... That said, they're mer... Anyway, if you could let them know.
You know where the merchant's at? What kind of merch are we talking about?
Boxes of equipment for your quartermaster. From Alliance.
From Alliance? Our rival corporation?
Just one of the many, like Aurora. But Alliance, being at the cutting edge of military research, clearly has goods your quartermaster is interested in.
And what's the merchant buying?
Mostly exotic ammunition. The kind used for hunting. Different prey require different rounds, from my understanding. The more exotic the prey.
I hear you. Thanks. What kind of merch are we talking about?
Boxes of equipment.
From a lot.
Just
and
more.
I...
Look at you. Glad to see you. Can't tell you how much your help was. It is appreciated. Well, things might have worked themselves out in time, but who has time these days? And you sure saved me the hassle. You're a technomancer?
I am. Zachariah Mancer.
I'm lucky, in name and in life. You mancers all stick together. Know each other real well, don't you?
Know each other, maybe, but we're scattered between here and the front.
Right, right! The front. Of course, the front. So, I take it you know where I can find a... I believe his name is Master Connor?
He's still in town, away from the front, training recruits.
Lucky again. Just what I wanted to hear. Think you might be up to do me a favor?
Either way, I'm here. Tell me what you need.
Simple. To meet Master Connor and relay some information. With your help, of course. Without your help, well, being just a simple merchant, unwelcome outside the exchange, I suppose it'd be a bit harder. If not, you know, impossible. You know as well as I do, a common merchant can't just stroll up to the likes of a master. So, you get me in front of him, and I'll owe you one. How about that?
I'll see what I can do.
And I'll be much obliged.
Man! Nice man! Help, Meg! Please? Meg soon leave with Master Merchant. Meg need help, Man Lightning.
I guess that I can bring the stone, yes.
Yes! Man...
Where are you from? Goodbye, Meg. That spy. Maybe I should ask around. Hi.
Lieutenant, how can I help you?
I went to a friend for a solution to our antidote problem, and he found one.
That's the kind of good news you don't get every day. You could stop 100 terrorist attacks and still not save as many lives as you have with that antidote, Lieutenant.
Hi.
Lieutenant, how can I help you?
Hey, Ryan. Merchant just delivered this for you.
Said he's got more merch you may be interested in, too.
Oh, good. Bastard finally showed up. Damn foreigners. Good thing they're better at making deals than they are at minding their clocks or calendars.
Lieutenant?
I want to know my men better. Tell me a bit about yourself.
Oh, great. Show and tell. Yay.
What do you do when you're off duty?
Nothing special. See my folks, I guess. They ain't getting any younger, so... And I give most of my paycheck to them, because I'm the only one they got left. Sister died. And I ain't married, so... When I ain't with them, I'm at the bar, drowning the shitstorm that my life's become. Not exactly a picture-perfect life, but it's mine. And hell, I get paid enough to help them out and buy my own drinks, so what's there to complain about?
What do you think about Jeffrey Hunter?
He's a village idiot who thinks he can brown-nose his way to a promotion. Fucking reject. And no, he ain't my friend, if you haven't pieced that together.
I'm gonna leave you alone. Seems you'd rather be that way anyway.
Hey, Lieutenant. So nice to take a break, right? I wonder if I should go out for a walk. Need some fresh air.
Hi.
Lieutenant,
how much do you know about what's going on in the barracks?
Not much. And not really interested. I'm just a quartermaster, here to grease your wheels when they get rusty, not eavesdropper gossip. Why are you asking? What are you looking to know?
What do you know about Dave Ward?
Quiet, brooding, asshole type. Not a talker, which is fine by me because he's not one I want to talk to.
What about Jeffrey?
I don't want to talk shit about anyone, not my style. But that boy's only barely sharper than a spoon.
What have you heard about my captain?
If you're looking for me to dish dirt, Lieutenant, you're barking up the wrong tree. She may be a woman, but this army could use more officers like her. She'd put herself in front of a bullet for her men. The army's her church. It's sacred to her. And she will, and has, come to blows with anyone or anything that threatens to tarnish its image. Word is, she's got one hell of a right hook.
At your command, Lieutenant.
Have a second to talk?
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. Like, just you and me, or...?
Yeah, just you and me. I like to know my men.
Wow, that's... yeah, that'd be a huge honor, Lieutenant.
You have a good childhood?
Oh, yeah, you know it, Lieutenant. Really nice growing up, running around in the fields. Father gave me a crossbow, and I spent my time helping the farmers shoot critters hurting their crops. They were good times, Lieutenant. But everybody's gotta grow up and move on. There was a lot of hunters in Green Hope, too. Plus, I always dreamed of being a soldier. Mostly, though, because there was a girl back home who loved men in uniform, so... Off I went to the big city to join up. And, you know, since I was a sharpshooter, they signed me up and sent me here. Still not used to it. All the buildings, all the folks, all the concrete. But I'm happy, though.
So what's your life like when you're not on duty?
Tell you the truth, Lieutenant? Not much to tell. I try to visit the city, make some friends. You know, because I don't really know too many folks yet. And my whole family's back in Green Hope, which is kind of too far to travel for my leave. And, oh yeah, there's also, you know, I try to still do some hunting. Though there's not much more than small critters in the underworks. Not a great hobby for the city.
Colonel Ian Mancer came by looking for you. Hope this isn't going to be a habit, Lieutenant. His problems aren't yours anymore. You're part of my unit now. We clear?
Of course. I'll go see him on my own time, not yours, Captain. There was a professor, Charles Seeker, who disappeared a while back. I'd really like to find out what happened to him.
I don't know why I should give a damn when it has shit to do with your mission orders, Lieutenant. But if an answer will get you refocused on where your mind should be, give me a minute. Let me just begin by saying I really hope this professor wasn't a friend of yours, Lieutenant. And I'd hate to learn you're not a better judge of character than to befriend the likes of rebel insurgents. He's been sent to a re-education camp outside the city. Forget you ever knew him, Lieutenant. Even if he was just a friend of a friend, like, say, that old drunk you keep around, Scott Seeker, and I'll try to do the same. Show too much concern for enemies of the corporation, and one might find themselves labeled one too, Lieutenant. Please, choose your friends more carefully in the future.
Have a moment, Captain?
Depends what you need it for.
Just want to get to know you better, Captain.
I don't usually mix business and pleasure, Lieutenant, but ask away and we'll see which questions I feel like answering.
How was your rise to Captain earned?
Over time. But by no special action by me. Graduated as a corporal, and thanks to the brave men underneath me, their success and missions became mine in rank. No heroic feats to dazzle you with in stories. Just a lot of time and dedication that I'm proud of just the same.
You from Ophir?
Born and raised. Father was an officer. Mother was a quartermaster. And I've rarely ventured outside the walls but for a few scattered missions. Sound familiar, Lieutenant?
Very familiar, Captain. Except my parents weren't officers.
Which makes your rise even more noble, Lieutenant.
What do you think of us?
Honestly, Lieutenant? I'm not quite sure yet. You technomancers are new to me. Undoubtedly special, and capable of feats my other units couldn't dream of accomplishing, but time will tell. That said, I've been quite impressed. I thought it was the definition of insanity to send you and so few of your men on some of those missions. Missions I would have anticipated needing 10 times the manpower for. So far, you've proven me wrong. A rare feat in itself. So even though it's taking some time getting used to, I couldn't be happier you're one of my troops.
Can I ask about your relationship with ASC?
Tread carefully, Lieutenant. One might start to wonder the purpose of your questions. But here's my answer. We're all forced to work with them, but it doesn't mean I have to be happy about it. Too much power too quickly leads to arrogance. They're brash and too quick to act. And quite frankly, as they've risen in power, it's no coincidence that the dissenters, deviants, and rebels have risen in numbers. They're a great source of intel, however they get it. I sleep better at night not knowing the means. But I've always thought the army was strength enough, that the ASC was overkill. I trust you won't repeat anything I've said, Lieutenant. I'd hate for both of us to find ourselves enemies of the state over a little frank conversation.
My lips are sealed, Captain, and I appreciate your candor and trust. More than you know.
Maybe I'll use that time off to go visit my mother.
Maybe I should take this opportunity to look into this spy. Or we can take a little rest. Feels like a Green Hope souvenir stand. Kid must be missing home. Unless being messy's a crime, though. Doesn't look like he's doing anything wrong. I can't open it without a code. Unfortunately, this is beyond my skill level.
Everything's clean in here. Looks just like the captain's work. Nothing that implies she's working with the ASC.
Unfortunately, this is beyond my skill level. I can't open it without a code. I can't open it without a code. I can't open it without a code. Maybe I should take this opportunity to look into this spy. Or we can take a little rest.
At your command, Lieutenant.
How do you like Dave? You guys get along?
Oh, yeah, sure. I mean, he's not always the happiest guy in the world, but it's probably because he didn't have an easy life. He's always talking about how his life was nothing before 126 and joining the army, and that his family's all he's got. He's kind of bitter, but he's probably got a right to be. I always cheer him up, though, hoping he'll loosen up over time.
It's got my whole schedule in here, and the names of every single person we saw together. Must have been Dave keeping tabs on me the whole time. Never would have believed it. Guess if you could spot them, though, they wouldn't be so damn powerful.
Lieutenant? Lieutenant?
I know you're a drinking man, so what do you say we go grab one together?
Looks like it's my lucky day. Sure, why the hell not? Lead the way. So why don't you cut the bull and tell me why we're really here?
Sure.
You've been spying on me, Dave, and reporting everything back to Victor. I don't like rats. That's not all right with me.
And what? You think I ever had a choice in the matter? Think I had the option to say no?
I don't care. All I know is they got all the intel they wanted on me from one of my own soldiers, and I don't know why. What's your angle, Dave? You bitter you got a Mancer as your lieutenant? I thought we were past all that. What'd they promise you? Promotion? Better pay?
Nothing but a promise they wouldn't hurt my parents. Is that a good enough reason? I don't like the ASC. Don't like what they're doing to Abundance. Don't like what they're doing to me. I don't like the deal they offered, and I don't like I didn't have a choice but to accept it. I ain't got no one but my folks since my sister died. Not that I expect you to shed a tear for me, but if I gotta choose between them and you, sorry, brother. You're on the losing end of that. If it helps, though, I don't think you're the full prick you were before we had this little chat. In fact, I might even have liked you in another time and place. But you're in deep shit now. And it's shit I don't want to get pulled into with you.
I don't want your blood on my hands, David, but I can't let you keep doing what you're doing. So I'm just gonna tell you to get the hell out of Ophir and don't look back.
I don't... sure. Yeah, sure. Bye, Lieutenant.
Hey, I'm looking for a guy. Used to fight in the arena. Name's Derek Labor.
Derek Labor? Yeah, I knew who that is. Heard rumors going around about him. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I heard Derek got himself into some shit with some Vori. He decided he didn't want to lose fights they were fixing or something. Just what I heard, but if it's true, I doubt you're gonna see him again. But you know, if you want to ask around, if it's about betting, talk to the bookie. He may know more. No one knows more about the fighters than he does.
Thanks. I'll do that.
Thank you. You came. Thank you. Let's get going as soon as possible.
All right, let's go.
Keep heading down this road. We're gonna be ambushed. Please, let's go back. I'm not going any further. We keep heading down this road. We're gonna be ambushed. Please, let's go back. I'm not going any further.
Lieutenant?
Soldier, listen up. This merchant's got intel about the mob's trafficking, so he's under the protection of Abundance. Take care of him, and make sure he gets his documents to the head investigator.
Yes, sir!
Thank you, officer! Thank you! Thank you! I thought I was gonna die! Thank you!
Veronica, I need a favor. I'm looking for access to the professor's compiled research documents. Might be a big help to me.
It's just not my work to share, Zachariah. If he came back, I don't think he'd be too pleased to find out I handed it away. You ever find out what happened to him?
From what I could gather, he was arrested and thrown into the correctional camp. Apparently, his criticism of the government was more important to them than his work. Times we live in, I guess.
I don't even know what to... Such a loss. A waste. Maybe his work shouldn't be abandoned. If he's not coming back anytime soon, or at all, and you can do good with it.
Hey there.
Officer, hello. What can I do for the fine officer today? Check out my merchandise. I have everything you'd ever need for hunting.
Hey there. Just came by to let you know Fiorello's back in the exchange, and he's got your merchandise.
Now that is some very good news. Thank you. I'll send my assistant right away.
Hi, you Jenny Labor?
Yeah, that's me. What can I do for you?
Nothing for me. A mutant named Beg sent me to give you something. A souvenir, or... I don't know. It's just a stone that he drew on.
Thank you. Oh, my dear little...
Hey there!
Hi, Scott.
Hello, my boy. How are you? Nothing broken, I hope.
Unfortunately, I've received confirmation of what Veronica suspected. Charles was arrested and deported to a camp as a punishment for his comments. I'm sorry, Scott. I did bring back his research, though, since you wanted it.
Thank you, Zachariah. A camp? How awful. But what is happening to our dear Abundance? We won't beat Aurora if we get rid of our scientists. Anyway, I'll take a look at these documents. No doubt our dear Charles was worried. They're coded. It's funny, it reminds me of the code we used as students, so that the professors wouldn't know about our adventures. All this is a little far away. I'm gonna have to think about it. Thank you, Zach. Thanks again.
Hello, Beg.
Oh, hello! Man, have orders for Beg?
I'm sorry, Beg. I gave your stone to your mother, but she died. I believe that she committed suicide because the police were about to arrest her. She put the stone in her mouth and died.
Mother? Mother dead? No!
I'm really sorry. I didn't think that she would do such a thing. Hey there, Fiorello.
Ah, the one, the only, Zachariah Mancer. A pleasure, as always. What brings you here this fine day?
I found your clients. Told them you had their merch. They'll come pick it up as soon as they can.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Please, take this. As a token of my appreciation, it is not much for all you've done for me, but it's something.
Hi, Scott.
Hello, my boy. How are you? Nothing broken, I hope.
What can you tell me about the slums?
That's where the true Ophir is.
That's where I have my clinic, you know.
Of course, you know. I love that neighborhood. It's very lively, and you can find everything a poor doctor needs. Bars, patients.
I can see your interests are very specific.
You're not going to lecture me knowing that you yourself take focus drugs and other crap regularly. And it's too late at my age anyway.
Master Connor isn't in the chapel. The Great Master will know where he is.
Zachariah, a pleasure as always. What may I do for you?
I wanted to talk to you about something.
What about?
We're looking for a scientist who disappeared. Name's Charles Seeker. All I found is some of his research. Seems he was studying technomancers. Before getting arrested and sent to a camp.
Charles Seeker? Yes, the geneticist. Geneticists pose a risk. Scientific discoveries are always threatening to expose our secrets. Your friend Scott even worked on the same research years ago. Never found out what Scott did or didn't discover, though. He ended up drinking himself into irrelevance. So I stopped worrying. Whatever research you found, make sure no one sees it. Could be our downfall.
I'm looking for Master Connor. Any idea where I can find him?
He headed down to the Underworks. Needed to get some supplies from our warehouses. If you're going there, take the elevator near the barracks. Opens up close to the warehouses and will save you some time. It's a real maze down there.
Thanks for the tip. I found the mole. David Ward was running lines for the ASC.
In these times, spies are everywhere. They used to be like rats, but now bear more resemblance to cockroaches. Should you see one, you can be certain 100 more reside in the walls, each placed there while their arms were twisted by the ASC. So, what happened with this Ward?
I couldn't find it in myself to kill him, so I released him and let him run, like a rat. I would assume he's still running and we'll never see him in Ophir again.
The full blame cannot be cast on him. There are few who the ASC cannot bend to their will. We'll cross our fingers. Hopefully this soldier is gone for good and does not find himself arrested before he should escape.
Your command, Lieutenant.
Hello.
My dear, dear Zachariah, a pleasure as always to see you, and my gratitude for your help. Now, please, stop calling me Master. You're one of us now. What brings you here?
I met a merchant fresh off the exchange who'd like to meet you.
Strange. Some delivery I'm not expecting, or something else?
He only said he had information to give. Didn't say what, but I thought maybe there was a chance he learned something about some relics during his travels.
Relics are more the Great Master's field of expertise than mine. I like to stick to molding our young recruits, but come. Let us see what this is all about.
Going on, but this is weird. Better follow Master Connor to the exchange to make sure nothing happens to him.
Really, you? Andrew? Can it really be?
I hate to disappoint Master Connor, but I don't die easy. And I have a little too much pride to just let myself be tossed out with the trash. We got some explaining to do.
We did not toss you out with the trash. We just did not know how to help you. Your talents were uncontrollable. So we sent you away, hoping you would forget and move on.
Hoping I'd forget? When? As 10 years of my life wasted away at the hands of a merchant? I want my goddamn life back, asshole.
I'm so sorry. I don't know how I could make it up to you. I
don't know. But you can be damn sure I'll think of something. Get out.
Andrew, I cannot tell you how remarkable to see you. Simply remarkable. Pardon me, Zachariah. You cannot know how unexpected this was. Thank you. I must now return to the source.
I'm a little bugged I had to listen to that conversation. I don't even know what the hell they were talking about. Who's that kid Andrew they were going on about?
I was wondering the same thing. Name's familiar, but I don't know.
Thank you.
guys, let's get him!
Hey, new blood to the neighborhood. Name Sam Rowe, bookmaker at the Curiosities. Which means I not only take bets on the fights, but I set them up too. So, whatever your flavor, I'm your man. You a betting man or a fighting man? Care to dance?
More a fighter, I guess.
Yeah, you seem the sort. We got two types of damage cards, see? On-demand fights, for the beauty of the sport, and a tournament where the fighters, instead, gotta take on a number of challenges. You win them all, you take the title, and a reputation to not fuck with you.
Sure. Why the hell not? Could use a little exercise.
That's what I'm talking about! Follow me to the arena, fresh meat. They're gonna love you. Hello there. Ready for a fight? A challenge?
Tell me more about the challenges in different rounds.
Sure, sure. Each round's got three challenges. This round remains on home turf, but the future rounds will find the local champs fighting those from other cities. You win the last round, you win it all. You're the champion of Mars!
Who or what do you fight in the challenges?
You can fight other guys, or there's some who come to only fight the creatures. Either way, the further you go, the stronger your adversary will be. Each subsequent challenge pushes the limits.
Good one, son.
Here, here. Ah!
Atta boy! Damn! Damn impressive! Your reward for victory! impressive. Your reward for victory!
Good luck!
Boy! Damn! Damn impressive! Your reward for victory!
Ah!
Damn impressive! Your reward for victory! Hey there, new blood. What can I do you for?
I'm looking for a man named Derek Labor. He fought here?
Guess you've earned a bit of honesty from me. Poor Derek. Poor, poor Derek. Hit a snag. Snag so big it got him knocked out. If you catch my drift. There were two fellas after him. More likely that they did him in than the story going round that he simply choked drinking from a glass, don't you think? Strong fellow like that.
Where can I find the guys?
They're Vori, Mancer. So I'm guessing you can find them hanging around Anton Rogue's warehouse. But I didn't tell you that.
I'll keep you safe. Thanks for the help. Word is, you're the guy who paid to kill Derek Labor. The guy who won his last fight in the arena a few days ago.
Fuck you! Who the hell you think you are coming in here like this, prick? How about we teach you a lesson in manners? How about that, boys? Stop! Stop, dammit, stop! We're the ones who shot Derek.
And who sent you to do it?
Shit, it was that fucking guard who watches over the fights. He wanted Derek gone. I don't know why, so don't ask. I just took what he paid, and I did what he asked, all right?
Yeah, all right. An honest killer. What'll they think of next? Later.
Yeah!
Hello, Alan.
Zachariah Rogue. They haven't sent you to die at war yet? A damn disappointment.
Does the name Andrew mean anything to you?
A merchant's son whose dreams of technomancy died with him. A case study of someone trying to be greater than he was born to be. A lesson you might want to learn yourself, lest you risk the same ends. A mirror image of you, basically. A loser.
I have two witnesses telling me you're behind Derek Labor's death. Why'd you do it?
Shit. Why did I do it? You know how much that little bitch cost me in serum? Papa's little ass was supposed to go down in the last fight. But no. He decided he needed to follow the rules. Being a pathetic Labor who started winning fights swelled his head. A little arrogance goes a long way in the arena. You get hurt outside of it, though, he was supposed to lose. He didn't. That hurt me really bad. So, I made an example of him to other fighters who think they can think for themselves, too.
You're under arrest for the murder of Derek Labor.
Yeah, sure. You and what army officer? Get out of here.
Yeah!